Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Nitty Digit Podcast. I am your host, Jennifer, aka Jay, and welcome. If you are new, I'm so glad you found me. And if you are returning, thank you so much for coming back and enjoying my madness. I'm just gonna jump right in and show you what's on my needles. So, first off, my contribution to the knit along, paint along children's literature and children's and young adult literature is the Evain, excuse me, the Evain pattern by Feministy, aka Liz Abernathy. And I kind of looked and I realized that Sturtis is kind of with Sturtis is the novel by Neil Gaiman. It really isn't a young adult or children's literature. I thought it was, but it's not. But it's still kind of fantasy like, but the yarn, it still counts in my knit along because the yarn is from Sunshine Yarns and the name is PETA for Hunger Games PETA. So it still counts. So this is what I have so far. I thought maybe I'd be done with it, but I'm not. Kind of show you where I'm at. I finished the seed stitch stockinette section and now I'm on the garter edge. So I'm almost there. Almost there. This is the yarn is in her classic sock base. So it's a usual merino nylon. The needles are from Signature Needles, size US 3, and I forget the millimeters, so forgive me. So this is what I have so far. I'm hoping that I'll finish it today. Today, which is Sunday, because after this I'm just gonna be lazy. So, yep. That's what I have on that. Ta-da! I'm loving it. I'm loving it. It's very nice. I would have been finished if I wasn't reading. I'll talk about that later, but I'll probably finish it today or maybe tomorrow. That's one. All right. What's next? What's next? So the next one. I have a hoe. I have me a hoe. This is my traditional Gansey sock by Wendy Johnson in her Socks from the Toe Up book, her first one. And the yarn is Lisa Souza. Lisa Souza in her BFL sock base. And the colorway is Seashore, by the shore. I'll give you the label in a moment. Ta-da! I have me a hole. It's a little roomy because I did it in 1.5s, and with the stitches around, it does kind of give me a little room, not as tight as I like it to be, but it'll still work. It'll fit in my clogs. So that's what I have. All right, let me show you what I have. I just have so much piled up. All right. So then I started on the toe. So I started on the toe and I have a little bit of the foot done on this. So as I said, not much knitting. Not much knitting in the sense of I could have been done with this if I kept going, but because I have so many other projects going on, this is as much as I can do. But I'm getting there. I'm getting there. Needles are US 1.5, as I said, 2.5 millimeter in my Hiya Sharps. No, excuse me. Excuse me. My Addy Turbo. My Addy Turbos. That's right. Addy is the 1.5. There you go. And here's the label. The shore. I was right the first time. Elisa Souza. EFL stock. That's sure. And it was born January 18, 2010.
Mm-hmm. 3 years.
I'm getting there. I'm getting through my stash. One sock at a time. All right, so that's that. What else do I have? Well, what's missing?
This one?
Ha! I have me another hoe. There's so many hoes in this house. Excuse me. So this is another Wendy Johnson pattern. It is the lace and cable. Again, in her socks from the toe up. And the yarn is also a Lisa Souza BFL sock. This is called Sky Drama. This one is just right. This is just right. So I think I'm definitely going to stick with ones on these toe up socks. I'm very happy with this. Very, very happy. Alright, so what else do I have? Let's see. I also did some of the toe and part of the leg on this. This is a, as I said, US ones in my higher sherps. So as you can see, I did the toe and now I'm on part of the leg. This one, it'll probably go faster because the pattern is less counting of stitches and more of just remembering where you are in the pattern. So this will probably fly by and less stitches, obviously. So. Ta-da. Here's the label. And both, I have sufficient amount of yarn to make it. See, I have about the same in the other one. Well, the color, you're not really seeing the blue and the purple's coming out red. It's more of a purpley. My color, it's not as sunshiny today. So that's probably why it's not as a color, true color on my camera. So again, Lisa Souza. And her BFL sock Sky Drama. And this was born September 21, 2009. As I said, going through. All right, that is it for my knitting. I slowly but surely knitting through my socks. And I am enjoying it. Definitely the shawl has gotten my knitting mojo up. So that was very nice. So once, I think I'm going to keep going with the shawls and knitting up some of my stash that is older, but also I haven't designated a pattern that's not socks. So I think if I have a shawl on the needles or something that's not socks, I will keep my mojo. Nails. Let's go on with the nails. So right now, I have gel on my nail, which is usual. So, but this time I have the color on my nails rather than the usual undercoat. So I have Bella's Vampire. And now you're trying, do you wonder what this is for? I wonder. Twilight. So here you go. Gelish Mini, Bella's Vampire. And I have to say, it is definitely much better than the Lamassi. It does shrink a little on the sides, not on the top. So you still have, you know, the ability to wrap your tips without it thinking that it's going to shrink. It does shrink on the sides, though, which is fine by me. But you can kind of see I did kind of get some on my nails on this side. I'm still practicing on this side of the hand. But you notice, what's that sparkle? Well, because it's twilight, you gotta get the vampire to sparkle, right? Right? So, I added some Julep Adele, which is a shimmer. I really like how it transformed on the nail. You can kind of see, but it's shiny and sparkly and shimmery. So, this is Adele. Kind of try to show you. So I did not cook this in the gel top coat. I did my usual top coated the Bella's Vampire, and then I put this on top and then put my posh. So that way, once it starts to kind of get raggedy, I can take it off and put something else on top, which I have another Twilight themed. Now, I'm gonna go a little bit off track and again ask this question. Would you rather go with this or would you rather go with this? I'm just saying, I like this. But if you like this, then you should explain it to anyway, back on track. All right, so what else has been on my nails since the last time I podcast? Well, as I said, I took off the little mossy. I just couldn't. Oh, it was just so bad. Because I added the shimmer, the Adele shimmer over that one too, because I wanted to hide it. I was just like, oh no, I can't do it. So as I was editing, I took it off and I did my usual clear undercoat, gel undercoat, and I put, because I could not wait any further, I put on some Zoya Liberty. Not Liberty, excuse me, that's blue. This is London. So I have that. Pretty. And then after that, once that kind of died, that lasted about 2 days. Only because I think you don't try to wrap your textures, it just doesn't work. So I then went, and this lasted a good amount of time, one of my California Coast collection from Julep, the Fay, which is a nice brown shimmer. It really reminded me of the sand. Pretty sand. Also reminded me of this picture book that I used to read as a child called The Sandpipers. I just didn't post it on the board because I completely forgot, actually, to be honest. But that lasted me for a while. And then I had my singing recital that weekend, so I decided it needed to be fun and perky and not perky, but just fun. And I've been really getting into holos, and I kind of went fun fantastic with my nail budget, nail polish budget, and you'll see this later, but I got from Lacquer Lust Venus. So I put that on my nails, and that was fun. The light's not showing it very well, but it's like this beautiful black base. And it's holo purpley blue, and it just is just so much fun. I have a little video of it later on, which I'll show you. That lasted me a couple of days. And then I decided I really wanted a nice lighter color, which was why I went with London, because I've been liking the dark colors on the toes, lighter colors on my fingers. So I went with, I put under it OPI, My Point Exactly, which I did forget to take out, but it's a nice light gray base that looks, it just looks like nothing on my nails. And then I topped it with, again, a new purchase, which I will talk about later. Serum number 5, Love Lacquer in Her Fame. And it looks like this. And it's just this beautiful, beautiful light gray holo. Not showing it, of course, because, well, because it's my room and you can't see it. But it's just a beautiful holo. I have a picture of it, of course. But it's so pretty. I got a mini one. So pretty. It was very nice. This lasted me a long while, long, long while. And then I took it off and I had my nails bare for a couple of days. Just a couple of days. And then painted my nails. And there you have it. I've been having a lot of fun with holos lately, so there will be more in my future. I foresee it. So, and it's just, I think it's the best nail polish for the summer because the sun is out and then the colors dances off your nails and it's just a lot of fun. It's just, I like it. And you can do it in like colors and you're not feeling like you're in winter nail mode. So, anyway. So that's what's on my nails. Books. Books, books, books. So I kind of have now, completely forgot to bring my phone in. I wanted to show you some websites because I'm still in the Outlander series. I finished the first book and I went on with the second book and I started thinking, like, what am I going to read after this? I know once I finish the series, I'm going to be wanting something very similar to this, or I'll be stalking Diana Gabaldon's website for her new book. So I started thinking, well, all right, this is a great way to show how other librarians figure, create their lists or figure out, just kind of show different methods. But I need my phone for this. So hold on 1 minute. Try to go as fast as I can. All right. So the first thing I want to show you is Good Books. If you are not on Good Books, you really should get on Good Books. It really is a really good, it's a really great website. And it's a good website. So go to goodbooks.com. GoodBooks.com. I think it's S. Let me see. Oh, not Good Books, Goodreads. Excuse me. GoodReads.com. And it had you have an iPhone and an Android, and it looks like this. And you can follow your friends, you can collect, you can show what you've read, what you want to read. It helps me keep track of what books I want to read, and keep track of books that I have read. And they also have, oops, what they have are lists. So if you're looking for a certain genre, they have lists for this. Or if you want to know what's the most popular fiction going on, they have lists for that. Or the greatest classics, they have lists for that. So I think it's a great source. But there's also something called whatshouldireadnext.com. And it looks like this. And basically what you do is you type in an author or a book that you just read that you want to read more of, and it gives you suggestions. And this one is actually better than the one that I had before, which was called Library Thing. Let me find it. Library Thing suggests. Librarything.com, and it has a book suggester, but it didn't work. Like, I kept typing in Outlander and it would not show me any results. So this is not, I don't know what's going on with their technology, but it was not working. So I really suggest that you check out the site whatshouldireadnext.com. www.whatshouldireadnext.com. WHATIREADNEXT.com. And it looks like this. And this is actually very accurate to how it is on the computer too. And you type in here, let's see, let's Outlander. Ooh, spell it correctly. And pick, and it gives you the results. I don't know if you can really see it, but see, I wish I could do this with my Kindle so you could have a bigger source, but I had it bookmarked in my Chrome and I don't have Chrome on my Kindle, so. But like, so I used this and I found out that what's close but not similar was this book, which was in my library. My sister let me borrow it before she, when she visited with us one time. Yeah. I'm like, oh, so maybe I'll read this after I finish the series. Of course, Stephen King is not romance, but it's a historical fiction. So that was one part of the genre. Because Outlander is very expansive in regards to his genre, it's historical fiction, it is a romance. I consider it fantasy as well, girly fantasy. So I don't think he's girly fantasy, but it's kind of in the same vein. So this is what I'm going to be reading next. Another book I found that is actually a whole new author for me was, let me find it. This is where I go to Goodreads and look for to read. Here you go. It is called The Winter Sea by Susanna Kearsley. I've never heard of her. I've never read her. So this is going to be a f I like expanding my reading. So it's exciting. She'll be next too. Of course, after I finish all the Outlander books. I'm so excited. And apparently there's a series coming out on Stars. I don't have, of course, cable or any sort of cable. When I say cable, that means I have nothing, not even the local channels. So I may be befriending people with cable that has Stars so I can watch it. They're filming it now. And they already casted Jamie. Anyway, I've been so obsessed. I've been trying to get all my friends to read it so I can talk about it. Just like with Hunger Games. I told my friend, read the series. She's like, okay, I will. I'm like, no, read the series so I can talk about it. And of course she read it after. I'm like, oh. But I'm not gonna push. I'm not gonna push. All right, so that's book talk. Let's see, no wish list because again I went wee. I already showed you my lacquer lust. Again, Venus. She's coming out, and I'm actually really excited. She's coming out in September. Her gemstone collection, which is basically every month's gemstone, and aquamarine, which is. Aquamarine is March and it looks so pretty. They're all holos. Holo! So I'll be stalking her. I really loved this one. It was just so pretty. And then, of course, I showed you Fame by Serum Number 5. She has some holos, but she also has the glow in the dark ones. So if you have not checked her out, check her out. So Lacquer Lust is a 3 free. I don't remember which one she's out of, but I know she's 3 free. Serum Number 5, she says, always free of formaldehyde, toluene, and dibidol phthalate. 3 free. So this was Fame. I also got from her because she turned 1 years old. Her business became 1 year old. So I used a coupon and got another mini called Starry Nights. There you go. And I'll, of course, take it out of the box. Don't worry. The thing is, her boxes are really hard to open. So I don't blame her, but they are hard to open without tearing. So this is Starry Night. And the stars are holo. So it's a glitter. It's a blue base with glitter. And the star glitters are holo. So this will be fun to have on your nails. This will be fun to have on my nails too. It probably won't go with the dark vampy purple that I have on. But later on, when I have black. So that's the other thing that I got. I also, so a couple people sent me things as well. The TFIMP forum group on Ravelry, they had a finger spotted giveaway type thing, and I won. Yay! So that got in the mail. I'm excited to try this. I was reading reviews, and I've heard that it is kind of finicky, and some people got results, some people didn't, so that will be interesting to see. So I'll show you that later. But I'm thinking it could be a great Skittles Manny. Well, no, because it's only 2 colors, huh? Yeah, we'll see. All right. I also, someone sent me more of the Vitagel that I used for my base. And then she also gave me, is this it? No, this is it. I rearranged my yarn, which I'll talk about later. She sent me the Vitagel, and then she sent me this. Really pretty. I think I'm going to use this with a shawl as a kind of accent. It's Lotus Yarns Tibetan Cloud Fingering. It's 100% Tibetan yak. Really pretty. Pretty. That's it. Wow, I'm just busting through here. All right, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. First, let's talk about the giveaways that I have. So July finished up, and we got some good posts from Rose Bob and Iggy Star. And so I spoke with Iggy Star a few days ago, and she wants the pattern. So Rose Bob, if you're watching, you have a choice between... You have a choice between these two nail polishes, the Mahogany Magic, and the Dress Me Up Pink, the Dress Me Up, which is a pink, nice dusty pink. So you have a choice of these two, and you have a choice of both of these Sunshine Yarns. One is Her classic sock, 100% superwash merino wool, in the Southern Sea colorway. All right. Or you can use the merino sport, which is also 100% superwash merino, but it's sport weight, called Hidden Cove. All right, so Rosebud, let me know which ones you want and your address, and I will send it to you. And the other winner, Iggy Star, let me know what pattern you want. Of course, it will have to be, the max will be $5, because I'm not rich. But just let me know which ones you want, and I will send it out to you. Also, a little bit of business, more business. Again, I said the stitch markers have from my Purple Goddess giveaway. I have not heard from Eichel Knitter, IKKLEKNITTR, about the stitch markers. These lovely, lovely stitch markers. So, again, I am going to wait another 2 weeks, and if I'm not contacted, I am going to pull from, I'm going to do a random number generator from that post again and get and send it to another person. Okay. And then if that person's win, I will notify them in the next podcast, and I will wait for them to contact me again. That is my decision, and I'm sticking to it. So again, these are the beautiful, beautiful stitch markers that Purple Goddess Designs, from Purple Goddess Designs, Alicia. I'm using the ones that she gave me, and they are just absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. So I really think you should collect this, Eichel Knitter. Mm-hmm. But if not, someone else will enjoy it. All right. What else in et cetera, et cetera, et cetera? Well, I told you about my singing recital. It went really well. Unlike last time, everyone and their mother and my mother went to the recital, and it went really well. And my friends took pictures, so I have a couple of pictures of that. No video. There is one from Instagram, but I can't seem to get it from her, and it's actually not really that good. It doesn't, because with Instagram you only get 15 seconds, it didn't really encompass the song very well. So so that was great. Goodness, what else? I'm trying to think what else has been going on. Not a lot, really. Just kind of hanging out, getting more involved with my friends. I feel better. So I've been taking advantage of feeling better by cleaning my house. That's why I'm actually podcasting on Sunday, because Saturday, I was supposed to go to a birthday party, which, by the way, happy birthday, Kimberger! She doesn't watch. She keeps saying she'll watch. I'm like, it's okay, you don't have to watch. But anyway, it's her birthday today. But I was supposed to go, but ended up, she wasn't feeling good and canceled, so I ended up having a free Saturday, and so I spent that day grocery shopping and doing other chores that I haven't been able to do, and then hung out with another friend of mine who I don't see as much because we're always so busy. So I got to hang out with her. So then I said, okay, I'll podcast Sunday, and I cleaned my house. Everything is smiley. So I'm taking advantage of my good time. Trying to think what else. Wow. Not much, really. I am in a happier mood. Oh, yes. So that's what I wanted to talk about. I did get a message saying, I hope you're still enjoying podcasting. I do still enjoy podcasting. I wouldn't do it if I wasn't enjoying it. So no, I really do enjoy it. It's just trying to explain that I can't do a lot of giveaways if, you know, not many people are participating. If I don't see the end product, you know, I would totally do it if I saw a huge end product. But you know, I had to be practical. So that's the only thing. And I'm sorry of being cranky pants, but you know, it just happens that way, being cranky pants and all, when you're not feeling good and then you're not, you know, you're not. I was trying to be as nice as possible. So I really hope that didn't convey as, oh, I'm just doing it for you. No, I'm doing it for me. This is only for me. I talk to a camera because I'm vain. I really am. And I just love talking into a camera. So, and just sharing my obsessions. So it's I do this for fun. I don't really expect much. So, but I do hope to have, you know, a good amount, and I have been getting the results that I wanted. I've actually gotten more than I expected. I thought I was just gonna have two viewers and me, so I've gotten a lot more than expected. So no, this is, I'm having fun. So don't think I'm not having fun, because I am. All right, I think that's all I can ramble about. I'm boring this week. Ugh. But anyway, oh, I want to show you my shirt because people will probably say, what's on her shirt? Lean in. Say something awkward. It's a boot shirt. And it's kind of making fun of the 8-bit computer games that people used to play. I used to play this one, I forget, it's like Adventure to Monkey Island or Pirates of Monkey Island. It's about this guy who wants to become a pirate. And he goes through these trails and he goes through these adventures and he ends up falling in love with the governor of the town and trying to save the governor from in the Monkey Island. And at the very end, you know, they do the kissing and all that stuff. And this really reminded me of this, and I had to have it. So I love my Kiki shirts. I haven't been buying them a lot lately because, one, I haven't been very impressed with a lot of the boot designs lately, and two, trying to save money. So I'm actually adding a little bit more to the nails, unless, and I also don't have much room for them. So I actually did a good amount of cleaning. So, oh, I did say, so sorry, backtrack. I did say that I was going to talk about my yarn organization. So to kind of show you, I have my knitting here. A lot of moving. Sorry, you guys, if you just hold
My
on.
window. Ugh. So if you can kind of see, I'm trying to do it. That's the top. And they kind of give you, that's the chair. So I actually have a lot of stuff usually. I have my, oh, sorry, you guys. I usually have a thing of water right there. So, all right, so let's go back. That's my yarn. See? That's my yarn. So when I moved, I got these. When I moved from my parents' house to here, so I kind of give you a shot. So, and by the way, this is how I do it. So that's why half the time I don't show you guys. I try to get everything in order because I can't move. I have to. You saw how it goes. So anyway. All right, so that's, so when I moved, okay, when I moved to my parents' house from here, I originally had all my yarns in like big wicker baskets, like all just shoved in there and put under my bed. Now that I have my own place, now that I have my own place, I decided, okay, I need to get things that really store so I'm not like throwing yarn hanks all over the place. So I first organize it kind of willy-nilly just so that I can get it put away and start working on my books. Actually, no. I did the books first, then the yarn, and then did some other stuff. And then when I realized that I couldn't really find much of anything, I decided to organize it by colors. So by cool, so light grays, you know, creams, blue, all the way to reds and very, very variegated. But I realized then I couldn't find anything. So I finally organized it.
as one librarian will do, by alphabetical order. Now, I could have done, if I really wanted it to be done, I could have done the fiction genre type of organization that public libraries do, and do it by fingering, lace, DK, but then there would be no organization really, because let's be honest, about 95% of my yarn is sock yarn. It's fingering weight. So that wouldn't have been very conducive or relevant. So I decided to go by alphabetical order. And so I was going through and I was organizing. I love organization. That was last week and that was last Sunday. And I did all that. And as I was going through organizing and whatnot, I pulled out skeins that I did not realize I bought. I actually, like, I thought I only had, you know, maybe 3 wool miza. I have 4. Yeah. No, not 4, 5. Yeah, I have 5. I thought I only had, like, 3 or 4. I have 5. I didn't realize that I bought some wool miza DK. I only bought 1. And it's a really pretty purple. So I was actually looking on the Wool Miza website to see if I could try to find the same one. I couldn't. I just couldn't. So I guess it's just going to be a nice shawl. I mean, it has enough yardage. I really want to make a sweater out of the DK weight. But yeah. And, oh, and another one. I did not realize Madeline Tosh. I thought I only got the lace width that I showed you guys the last time. And then the yarn that I got when I bought for Staff Appreciation Day, I didn't realize that I had another skein of pashmina in Smoky Organ. Did not realize. Yeah, didn't realize. I don't know if, hold on, let's see. I have 3 skeins of, Smoky Orchid, but one is in Pashmina, and this one is in, oh wait, oh my god, are you kidding me? I need to stop buying. So I have 2 in Pashmina, and 1 in sock. WTF. So, I mean, and you can tell they're kind of different. One's definitely a DK weight. I really think it is a DK weight. I think Pashmina is DK weight. And of course, the Tosh sock is fingering. So I don't think I can mix these together, especially since it's hand painted. And look at the difference. One is 100% hand superwash wool, so it took the dye very differently, darker, and then the pashmina is a lighter. I don't ask me how I could forget this. I think so. With the wool miza, I think I bought the wool miza be right before I moved. Right now. Let's be honest. I don't remember when I bought it. Let's be really honest. I don't remember when I bought it. Cause I'm thinking of the lace weight that I got. No, the lace weight came to my I buy too much yarn. I buy too much of anything. It's a good thing. Sorry for my reach. So this is one example. So now I can see everything, as you can see when I showed you. Now I know what yarns I have. I know exactly what yarns I have. So I feel better. My librarian heart is happy about this. So yeah, All right, I think I'm going to end it here before I just blow your minds. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in 2 weeks. And I hope you all have a great nitty-ditty day. Bye.
Everybody's been there, everybody's been still.